One night, Master Pfriem dreamed he was dead and on his way to heaven. When he got there, he knocked loudly at the door.
"I wonder," said he to himself, "that they have no knocker on the door. One knocks one's knuckles sore."
The Apostle Peter opened the door and wanted to see who demanded admission so noisily. "Ah, it's you, Master Pfriem," said he. "Well, I'll let you in, but I warn you that you must give up that habit of yours and find fault with nothing you see in heaven, or you may fare ill."
"You might have spared your warning,"
answered Pfriem.
"I know already what is seemly, and here, God be thanked, everything is perfect, and there is nothing to blame as there is on earth."
So he went in and walked up and down the wide expanses of heaven. He looked around him, to the left and to the right, but sometimes shook his head or muttered something to himself. Then he saw two angels who were carrying away a beam. It was the very beam which someone had had in his own eye whilst he was looking for the splinter in the eye of another. They did not, however, carry the beam lengthways, but obliquely.
"Did anyone ever see such a piece of stupidity?" thought Master Pfriem,
but he said nothing and seemed satisfied with it.
"It comes to the same thing, after all. Whichever way they carry the beam, straight or crooked, if they only get along with it, and truly I do not see them knock against anything."
Soon after this he saw two angels who were drawing water out of a well into a bucket. But at the same time he observed that the bucket was full of holes and that the water was running out of it on every side. They were watering the earth with rain.
"Hang it!"
he exclaimed, but happily recollected himself and thought,
"Perhaps it is only pastime. If it is an amusement, then it seems they can do useless things of this kind even here in heaven, where people, as I have already noticed, do nothing but idle about."
He went farther and saw a cart which had stuck fast in a deep hole.
"It's no wonder," said he to the man who stood by it. "Who would load so unreasonably? What have you there?"
"Good wishes," replied the man. "I could not go along the right way with it, but still I have pushed it safely up here, and they won't leave me sticking here." In fact, an angel did come and harness two horses to it.
"That's quite right," thought Pfriem. "But two horses won't get that cart out. It must at least have four to it."
Another angel came and brought two more horses. She did not, however, harness them in front of it, but behind. And that was too much for Master Pfriem.
"Clumsy creature," he burst out with. "What are you doing there? Has anyone ever since the world began seen a cart drawn in that way? But you, in your conceited arrogance, think that you know everything best."
He was going to say more, but one of the inhabitants of heaven seized him by the throat and pushed him forth with irresistible strength. Beneath the gateway, Master Pfriem turned his head round to take one more look at the cart and saw that it was being raised into the air by four winged horses. At this moment, Master Pfriem awoke.
"Things are certainly arranged in heaven otherwise than they are on earth," said he to himself. "And that excuses much. But who can see horses harnessed both behind and before with patience? To be sure, they had wings, but who could know that? It is, besides, great folly to fix a pair of wings to a horse that has four legs to run with already. But I must get up, or else they will make nothing but mistakes for me in my house. It is a lucky thing for me, though, that I am not really dead.